subtle doubling in tension. So this is my entire presentation in one sheet. You need to see anything, watch this. What I present is Protégé. It's a tool for the semantic web. And this is what I'm looking at. Code in Java, I do in semantic. No semantic agent can use. What it does do, however, is it exports the semantic agent. So what we have is Protégé. How many people here know about the semantic web? Work with the semantic web. Use Protégé. People use Protégé and don't work with the semantic web. Okay. But there are reasons for that. It has to do with this article. But here's Protégé. So if you have Protégé, download Fresnel Forms, and whatever ontology you have in Protégé session, you click this button called Fresnel. You click save as wiki, you have an XML, shoop, in your own wiki, and you're done. And that's all you need to know. You can read your emails for 20 minutes now, because this is basically. Oh, another important point is these sheets are on the slide check. So if you want to read a lot of them later, here they are. Under my name, we'll be able to do the slide check. So, you use Protégé, you download a plugin, you load an ontology, a data model on semantic web, into your Protégé session, and with this plugin, you can right away with one click of a button have an import for your wiki, and then you have a system interface with semantic data wiki, with semantic forms, plus with form data input and template. Here we say that. Form input gives you a lot of help. A lot of this help, this user assistance, is derived from the original ontology. And what you also get, it doesn't show here, you also get a template that shows the data that's been entered in the wiki. And what you also get is an RDF export. And the RDF that your wiki then exports conforms to the ontology that you began with. And what you also see here is that we use Wikipedia as a sort of role model for how the end interface should look. Anything about the underlying technology is completely different, but the actual pixel appearance is what we're trying to see if we can emulate. Now, maybe some of you have heard some of this before. 5 years ago back in Amsterdam, where I work, we have this conference, and I presented what I built on the wiki itself, mostly, and also with the wiki extensions in semantic forms. And the point then was certain features of semantic forms are useful for teaching students about the semantic web. 2 years ago in Berlin, I spoke about a new extension, our wiki forms, and what that allowed you was to download into your wiki an external semantic web ontology. This you have a special page, you click through the URI for a semantic web ontology, and you created, with the extension, an interface on your wiki. And what you can also do is download additional semantic web triples or code or data that adapts the interface. So you can put interface style specifications in semantic web code and download that as well. But this year, I moved it all on Protégé. Everything that deals with getting or editing the ontology is on Protégé, but also Protégé itself is the ability to export the wiki. So all the building of the interface happens on Protégé. Enjoying the results, that is of course all on the semantic media wiki. One of the main features very quickly is now in Java, of course. You get a tab on Protégé, you get a lightweight approach to the function of the interface, but you can also edit the interface. You can change how you fine-tune the interface, change what the forms parameters are going to be. You can also change on the Protégé plugin itself what the CSS is going to look like. You can save your specifications in the semantic web format for now. It's spelled Fresnel, but it's pronounced in French for now. And that is a almost quasi-standardized semantic web format for interface specifications. And we've also put our own extensions on that format to directly import sort of the structure of semantic forms. And you can import that to a wiki. Why lots of reasons. Well, there are four general reasons. One is you have an ontology that you need to conform to, and you quickly want to be able to make data that conforms to that semantic web ontology. And some people have government-issued regulations that require them to do this. So, use this tool to download your URL to type for, and with just a few buttons, you have your room, and you can make data that conforms to the ontology. Similarly, maybe there's an existing ontology online that has more or less the data model that you want, and you know you want that group that makes that type of data. So instead of not even really concerned about the semantic web itself, just have an existing model, and very quickly you want to use that model to go quickly right away. Press a few buttons, no thinking work, and you can get the results. If you do want to think, of course, you can adapt the default interface that you're given. Now, on the other hand, an external ontology, standardized ontology, and you want to use that as a basis to begin with. You want to do your own data modeling on top of that ontology, and then make a system that provides a user interface for that. You can also do that with Protégé. Because Protégé itself, of course, allows you to download or import ontologies that already exist online, but that allows you to extend the data model. And once you've extended the ontology, you can then generate the wiki from your extension. And another point is maybe you don't care about the semantic web at all. There's no existing ontology that you want. You just want to take a model-driven development approach to developing your wiki. Protégé lets you provide a reasonable GUI interface for developing that model. And then based on that, you can generate a wiki from it. So you don't really need to care about the semantic web to take this full approach. Now, this is how Protégé generally works. You can have one of your classes down, let you look at the class hierarchy. You can see a whole bunch of information about the class structures, what the domain and range structures, and how properties of the class relate to each other. And there are a whole lot of other tabs as well that give you similar things. It's not necessarily a very good tool for beginners, for the learning part. But once you understand it, you have a good collection of rich functionalities that help you to develop a data model, whether you want to be on the semantic web, or if you just want to make a wiki from it, or, of course, both. Now, this is what we made. You download Fresnel Forms from the website. There's a link, of course, in the slides. You install it in Protégé, and that you can do pretty quickly. Just put the jar file in the right directory on the system, and Protégé gobbles it right up, and you have a tab. When you go to that tab, you already have an ontology download. And you get this interface. First, in the beginning, it's empty, but you click on the generate default slide, and you get the display much like this. And you can edit the display you want to as well. Here you click on one or two properties, and you can edit what happens with that property. You can save what you've done, you can reload what you've done earlier to get the interface back. Now, when you save a mode for now, that's nothing to do with your ontology. You also have an ontology file, but that's separate. So you're keeping the style of the interface in a separate file when you're keeping the ontology in. And last but not least, save with you. Export an XML file that you can then directly upload into import, I should say, into the semantic language. So by default, you get this. What we've done here is we tried to imitate the interface of Wikipedia info boxes. And what we used as the ontology is DBP. And DBP, most of you know this, but it's sort of the reverse engineered semantic web ontology of what Wikipedia has. Another important fact about Wikipedia, of course, is all of the data on Wikipedia gets exported as DBpedia, and then becomes the core of the semantic web. So it's an important data. So if you load the DBpedia ontology directly, you get right away this default interface to it. Now, it doesn't look that much like this, but it has the same information. But most importantly, although it doesn't look good, it's free. You just clicked a few buttons and you got it. So, how can you do that? I had one of my master's students do his thesis research Charlie, what is an algorithm for automatically sorting the properties on a box? I'm not going into the details here, but that is used in our model to find a reasonable heuristic for automatically sorting properties. That's part of the default generation. If you don't like the default order, you can click on one of these properties and move it up and down. So you can get a default for free, you can pretty quickly fine-tune that problem of doing the case. You get a default form, it's in forms, you get a lot of forms and parameters that help you with inputs such as auto, category, and also data types, such as the date that was automatically recognized, also date type, so you get a date input type for that. And you know, like I said, you get range-based completion. This is all using the default. What you can also do is edit it to go beyond the default. And one of the key things you can do is to set a for each type of property, what type is it? Is it a URI? Is it an image? Or is it a link to somewhere else? And here are various CSS properties you can set for various aspects. I won't go into the details, but the thing to use is, again, Fresnel, that almost standard that I spoke about. It's a worldwide consortium note. That's what I mean by almost standard. You can handle semantic web cardinality, and it gets interpreted as a list of mandatory on semantic forms. And all of this you can specify, of course, within the Protégé tab. And then you get the Fresnel Forms editing interface. It looks a lot better, a lot closer to what you need to do. What you've been able to change is the order of the properties, that this is now an image instead of a URI, and CSS was entered in the Protégé Fresnel Forms plugin to look like the CSS of the semantic, of Wikipedia itself. And this is the adapted form. We've added some more parameters within our extension of Fresnel by the editing in Protégé, so that it results in more semantic data we can tell. Most of it is semantic forms parameters. Are there any questions until now? I'm almost done, I'll stretch. Yes. In Protégé, you can have your own ontology, the pro ontology, and you can have import ontologies to other things. And then you get all of the classes and properties from all the files. It happens to people. It doesn't get all of the classes and properties from all of the sources are handled in one big bucket of classes and properties. Although that is a possible feature. Now, we've done this for one info box. We've imitated the person info box on Wikipedia, but what about the rest? And our answer is you can do that. You can use this tool to re-implement Wikipedia. So, we can just give Jimmy Wales a call and tell him we're ready. You can take you take the DBpedia ontology, which has the equivalent of almost 4,000 classes. Load it into our system, we've done this. And then you can generate all the semantic forms and templates and property types and categories for everything on Wikipedia. And then you have basically an implementation from all the info boxes on Wikipedia. You can do this by default and you get a functional that is a quirky interface. And after that, you can have someone use Protégé to go through the 4,000 boxes and change the property levels and such. But pretty quickly, you can make a cleaner version, cleaner implementation of the info box on Wikipedia. Wikipedia won't want to do this. Several reasons are very valid and practical, but it could happen. Now, it took us, I have some tiny things in here. The default GUI interface takes a few minutes. If you load the entire ontology that's large and you click on generate default for now, it takes a few minutes. It takes about half an hour to generate the Fresnel code itself, and on a special server that's pretty high power, you can generate 80 code in about an hour. And then we haven't tried to test how long it takes a Wiki to import that code and turn it into forms code. But it's doable. But the nice thing about this is a batch job. You don't have to do it once, or you update it every couple of days or a week. doesn't have to happen live. So, yeah, we could take this tool to make Wikipedia pretty quickly with a lot of the things that I've worked. But the technical core is that we could use this tool to put info boxes on Semantic Web. Now, this huge table was our group's chart for how we map the features. And I've broken this down to three categories. I don't really have time to go into them, and I never had any intention of going into the details here. They might be handy for questions at the end. But what we have here is a bunch of features from the Semantic Web, a bunch of features that are already in Fresnel. And what we think, maybe we can send forms and other extensions could make a good thing to this one. And this is about the table we have in the presentation. Everything in pink we haven't done it. Everything in white we've done it. We can use this as our map to what people have done. And this is online, so if you're interested in some of the details, take a look. This is online too. This is the URL where you can download the forms, a wiki to us. And we have GitHub for it, and it says that we only use GitHub for the feature mapping for the issues. We haven't put the code on there, but people are interested in collaborating on this, I put the code on there as well. But here's the URL if you want to see what our open issues are and how we close them. It's mostly in Dutch, but every now and then it's English. But we do have a source code online with this SVN URL. You can't edit from it, but you can download it. We have a paper that we published soon that describes it. Here's me and here are the five students who worked in two teams and two separate bachelor's thesis projects to build this tool. They basically took what I presented 2 years ago in Berlin and replaced the PHP with Java on Protégé and then added a bunch of interface components, but they also extended the functionality and formalized what we say as a style specific. What would we like to do? Firmly, some of the big bits, we'd like to implement those. Keeping up and catching up with Semantic Forms, I put in a nudge link for Gary, but maybe the other way around, although I think Semantic Forms has very much more to offer this tool than the other way around. Formalizing the mapping between Semantic Web and Semantic Web. I'm interested myself more in business rules and how they would apply to making an enterprise review. I haven't presented any of that today. This is what I have students do, but my research is going like that. But what about research with you? Maybe we can collaborate on working on code and GitHub, maybe this broader project, maybe more directly. I have about 10 master's thesis students a year who all need to implement something and do research. And this one was a case study for how they want a particular type of business case done on Semantic MediaWiki. We could do some collaboration around that. And last but not least, these are the two teams of five bachelor's thesis students who did all of the implementation on this project. It was a lot of fun working with these students. And you see here, the last team had three very clear roles: the Protégé Guru, the Semantic Group, Web Guru, and the Semantic MediaWiki Guru. And those are my sheets. Within 20 minutes, I can get
yeah,
the
almost.
17 seconds for questions?
Yeah.
Who has this one question? Yes.
What about editing model uploading an edit version?
Uploading the what?
So in Protégé, you might add fields to change some structures, and then can you re-import the edit version into an existing one?
Okay. Oh, yeah. You can, of course. And so the question is, who's for everyone else for the recording? You've already made a way, you've already had a session, you've saved it as Fresnel code, and you've already exported the XML, and you've already imported that in your wiki. So you already have a wiki with forms and templates and properties and category pages into it. And you say, oops, I didn't want to let Pluto be implanted, or some change to the model. So you change the original model. And the answer is yes, 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 yes. And of course, there's a but. Yes, you can upload saved Fresnel code. You see the saved interface. You can change the ontology, that's what we're talking about. You can change the interface if you want to. You can export the new XML. You can import it into the same way because the interface is to import XML. All pages with the same page name will be replaced. All pages that didn't previously exist, all the forms and the templates and the properties Of course, the biggest but is if you already have data, of course, you already have filled in forms on pages. They're going to refer to all the old URLs. If you end up with the same page names, it will work out just fine. And how page names generally has an algorithm on the in Protégé. Minus one minute for questions? How are we on time? Another question, or should we move on to
We cannot have too much time, so maybe it's better in the next coffee break to have more.
Thank you all for your time. Thank you for the show. Thank you.
Thank you.